Hey guys, this is Jay Calderon with Jay on Boxing here, giving you a personal prediction for Jake Paul versus Tyron Woodley. And as always, this is just my take. Your prediction can be left down in the comments section below. Would love to hear them all. A little bit of fight info here. We have Jake Paul versus Tyron Woodley 2. This is a rematch of their August 2021 encounter. This will be taking place in Tampa, Florida, live on pay-per-view, Showtime pay-per-view, as a matter of fact. And of course, will be taking place in the cruiserweight division with, obviously, no title on the line. Well, guys, this is it. This is the one I've been preparing for the whole year. All my other picks have only been practice leading up to this particular fight. Of course, biggest fight of the year. Now, it's not the fight we expected, of course, but it's a fight nonetheless. And it's a rematch of their August Classic, which saw Paul tested for the first time en route to an 8-round split decision victory. Woodley, who replaces the injured Tommy Fury, was hoping for this rematch in the first place and went as far as to get a tattoo saying I love Jake Paul on his middle finger to do so. Sad. Well, this is the rematch. Here it is. One way or another, it happens. So will Woodley seize the moment this time, or does a more experienced but still far younger and fresher Paul improve upon his previous win in the return? Let's break this one down. Starting with Paul here. For Paul to win, I think he needs to jab to the body. He started that very well in their first encounter, and I think that did a number of things for him. Number one, score some points. Obviously, when you have two relatively inexperienced fighters, the guy who has longer arms, who can start scoring faster, who can really, you know, just put some punches on his opponent, it's going to build confidence, it's going to allow for him to get on the board, so to speak. It's only going to do good things for you. It's also a relatively low-risk shot if you have the longer arms, because it's hard to counter you in that way unless you just get really, really torched by just a great, well-thrown shot, which Woodley did not do a lot of in that first encounter. Also, for Paul, if you're trying to hit Woodley to the body, I mean, it's only going to do you good when you have a guy who's older, who seems to be a little bit trigger shy at this point in his career. I mean, you're taking the wind out of his sails this way. It can only lead to good results for you if you're Jake Paul. I would also say use combinations to back him up. Now, you don't have to back him up all the time, but you want to make sure that you're trying to take the fight away from Woodley, who I think might come in a bit more aggressive in this encounter, feeling like he maybe let the fight slip away from him the first time around. As a result of that, again, while you want to start out by jabbing and taking the wind out of him, what you want to do is make sure that you're putting it on him a little bit as the fight progresses so that you're, number one, staying out of way of his power being able to be generated, because he's a front foot thrower in the sense that Woodley has to be on his front foot to really generate power himself. And on top of that, it's just going to mean, obviously, your punches have more of an effect that will actually allow for you to hurt your man. Say what you want about Paul, but Paul has a solid right hand. He has put people down with it. He can throw it pretty well as well. I said as well too much there. But the point is that as a result of that, that means he can actually push him back and generate power on it, as opposed to having to try and do that when he was backing away and circling like he did in their first fight. So it doesn't have to be all the time, but he has to make sure he's trying to at least come forward enough to really generate some power on that shot and put Woodley down. Finally, stay off the ropes. In their first fight especially, that's where Paul seemed to get into the most bit of trouble. It's where he got tangled up. It's where he got hurt a bit. And of course, it means that you're being the one typically pushed back in that case. And he's just not a good enough fighter at this point in his career, whatever you want to call it, to be able to really counter well or pot shot there or set those kinds of traps. He needs to stay off the ropes. The trap he needs to set is trying to make the older man work. That's the trap he needs to set. Staying on the ropes really doesn't require Woodley to do that. It keeps him fresh, and a fresh Woodley is always going to have some power or some shot at being able to hurt Paul later in the fight. And there's really, if you're Paul, of course, no reason for you to allow that to happen. So circle, move, press him forward when you need to, jab to the body to get that started, and you're going to have some decent success in this fight, in my opinion. Going with Woodley here now, for Woodley to win, I think he needs to be more active. I mean, I really can't be much more cut and dry than that. That's what needs to happen. It's why I picked him in their first encounter. I thought he would be a little more active, at least early on, and would be skilled enough at throwing strikes that he could still hurt Jake Paul and maybe get him out of there. The issue is that he is so seemingly trigger shy at this point in his career that it just doesn't feel like he was able to get it done in that first fight. I don't know if he can do that in this fight, but in my opinion, he needs to be able to if he has much of a chance of winning this fight. If he's going to sit back in the pocket and look to land the single shot that will end the fight entirely, I just don't know if Paul's going to give him the opportunity to do that. He's probably going to be the fresher man, probably the better trained for this one, as Woodley is a late replacement. Woodley just can't afford to sit back in the cut and hope that that shot opens up for him. He has to kind of create the opening he's looking for. I would also say feint, then throw the right. You know, if you can add a little wrinkle to your game that as a trained fighter Woodley should have, I think it could potentially throw off Paul. If you're feinting enough and making him kind of have that herky-jerky response to it, and then one of those times throwing that right hand over the top of that feint, you could have some serious success. What you can't do is, again, sit back and do nothing. If you're not throwing punches, at least feint, at least flick out the jab a little bit to some degree. Do something to set that right hand up. But feinting is a good way of doing it without having to extend yourself too much as an older fighter. At least this will potentially help you set up a shot as opposed to you just looking for the opening and hoping it occurs. And finally, I'd say cut off the ring. One of the things that I think really irked me about that first fight was that Woodley just followed far too much. It was something where you looked at it and thought, well, he has to be able to cut the ring off. He's the more experienced fighter here. That's the only way he's going to get to the guy who's naturally a bigger fighter than him, has more reach than him, so on and so forth. And he just didn't do it. And quite honestly, cutting off the ring is not a particularly difficult thing when you're a guy, or shouldn't be, when you're a guy like Woodley, who has, you know, relatively fast reflexes. And again, while an older fighter should still have some of that in his reserve. It's very simple. Jab, feint, try and shepherd him into those corners and make sure your feet are on the outside of his. You'll corner him. It doesn't, again, against a relatively inexperienced fighter like Paul, it's not going to be that difficult to do if you put your mind to it. But if you're not doing that, then you really don't stand much of a chance of having too much success in this fight. In terms of my pick here, after seeing their first fight, I kind of sort of have to switch my prediction. Initially, I went with Woodley, thinking he would land a handful of shots, enough that would probably turn the fight in his favor and create a stoppage win. However, at effectively 40 years of age, I just don't think he's able to pull the trigger as well as he once was. I think he has some of that in him, but maybe not quite enough against a naturally bigger guy who's younger, fresher, pretty strong, and not the worst fighter I've ever seen in my life. And especially as a late sub, who may not have been in the best shape and maybe just kind of had to get put in there once Fury was injured, it's hard to say how good a shape he's even going to be in. I think Paul will be too sharp and too quick and avoid major damage and use that jab I mentioned, both up and downstairs, to keep Woodley at bay. Now, Tyron might start a bit hotter, one, because he didn't the last time, and two, because he might know he isn't in the best shape and kind of has to. But if Paul weathers that storm, his night could be easier than their previous encounter. Landing enough jabs and right hands on the night, I think Paul wins a more convincing decision this time as Woodley fades a bit more aggressively. Of course, I just switched picks, so naturally put all your money on Tyron Woodley. Nonetheless, my pick goes Paul via unanimous decision. Now, the betting odds for this fight are a little wider, I believe, than their first fight. Actually, I'm pretty positive. I think it was almost an even money fight, their first encounter. And here, you have Paul at a minus 310 with Woodley at a plus 225. Now, again, Woodley always has the potential to do something here, and Paul is still an inexperienced fighter. So, in terms of these odds, I mean, if you like Woodley to do it and would just like to see Paul get completely splattered across the canvas, which many of you, I'm sure, do, it's a reasonable enough bet because you don't have a lot of value in Paul the favorite here at a 3-1 when, again, that's not a guaranteed return. He is still inexperienced and anything can happen in boxing. Again, you might find some interest in maybe an over-under. This is such a weird fight to predict anyway. Like, who the hell knows? I don't even want to give you advice on that because anything could happen. But, you know, all I will say in terms of advice here is, and obviously do what you want with your own money and life, but all I can say is make sure the bets are small and that you're comfortable losing them. Because when you have fights that are this, just, you know what I mean? Like this, when they're like this, just make sure you're not, you know, wagering the house on anything. In any event, my prediction record is 48-20-4 with 16 exact. But let me know what you guys think down in the comments. How pumped are you for this return bout? Who are you looking to see get knocked out? Probably Jake Paul would be my guess. But we'd love to hear all your predictions, bets, so on and so forth. Please be sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, and follow at @JayCalderon_JOB on Twitter. And you can email me at jayunboxing@gmail.com. We'd love to hear from you there. Also, be sure to check out jayonboxing.com for schedule, results, betting odds, rankings, and more. Also, in the description box, check out a piece I wrote on Jake Paul about what boxing can learn from the young YouTube star. I would love if you gave that a click and a read as well. And please be sure to make sure to check out my fighter grades, which I will be releasing on Sunday. It might not include this fight that does take place on Sunday, but nonetheless, check that out as well. Of course, be sure you're subscribed so you will get the notification on that. And as always, until next time.